Good afternoon, children. In the previous class, we were discussing about the calorific value of a fuel. We also discussed about the different zones of flame. We also discussed what are the conditions required for combustion and many more. So now, in this session, we will just go through the numericals which is related to the calorific value. Then we will do a comparative study of calorific value of a fuel. Then we will know how to control fire. Then about fire extinguisher also we will learn. So first of all, the objectives. First of all, we will have a look on again on a calorific value and numericals related to it. Then the second one, how to control fire, and the third one is about fire extinguisher. In this we will learn mainly about soda acid type fire extinguisher. Children, first of all, we will have a look on calorific value. It is simply the amount of heat which is produced by burning 1 kilogram of a fuel in pure oxygen. That is amount of fuel. Amount of fuel which is expressed in kilograms. Now this is expressed in kilograms, and the amount of heat which is produced, which is expressed in kilo joules, and the calorific value will be kilo joules per kilogram. Now children, you just go through this table. Here it is given that the cow dung cakes when burned, that is 1 kilogram of cow dung cake burns and it produces about 6000 to 8000 of kilojoule. That is, the calorific value of cow dung cake is about 6000 to 8000. Now wood is 17,000 to 22,000, and you just see coal, it is about 25,000 to 33,000. Petrol, it is approximately 45,000. Then diesel and kerosene are also having the same. Then you see methane, it is having about 50,000. Calorific value of methane is about 50,000, and so the CNG and LPG is also having 50,000 of calorific value. From here, children, it is clear that cow dung cake, when we will compare cow dung cake to what? To petrol, or you can say LPG. So here, 1 kg of cow dung cake is burnt and it produces this much of energy, heat energy. On the other hand, only by burning 1 kg of LPG gas, it produces this much heat energy. So what is the efficiency of this fuel and this fuel? It is clear that from this table only, it is clear that the efficiency of LPG is much more than that of the cow dung cakes, because by burning only 1 kg of LPG, it releases tremendous amount of heat energy. On the other hand, by burning wood, you can say only 1 kg of wood is burned and it produces 17,000 to 22,000 of heat energy. So this is what we can compare, that LPG is the most efficient. That means efficiency of LPG is much more than that of the coal, or you can say wood, or cow dung cake, or petrol, anything. And this one is having the maximum efficiency, whereas the cow dung cake is having the least efficiency. That means its calorific value is much less than that of the LPG. So now I think it is clear. The calorific value, it is clear now. Now come to the numericals related to the calorific value. Here, children, you see that the calorific value of wood is 18,000 kilojoule per kg. It is given here. And the question is, how much of wood is required to produce 360,000 kilojoule of heat energy? So just substituting the data which is given here, calorific value is given. Calorific value of wood, it is given 18,000 kilojoule per kilogram, and you have to find out the amount of wood, and it is also given that the calorific value of wood is this much, and how much of wood is required to produce this much of heat energy. So now you go through the formula, calorific value of a fuel is equal to kilojoule per kilogram. Here the calorific value of wood is given, which is equal to 18,000 kilojoule per kilogram. And here also the amount of heat is also given here, that is 360,000 kilojoule. And what you have to find out? You have to find the amount of wood, that is the amount of fuel. How much fuel is required to produce this much energy? So suppose that the amount of fuel is X. Now we have to find out the X, which is the amount of wood. Now we will do the cross multiplication. So X is equal to kilojoule and kilojoule will be cancelled out. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. 18 ones are, 18 twos are, 20. Okay, now here it is 20 kg. Here, from here kg, 20 kg. So, the answer will be 20 kg of wood is required to produce 360,000 kilojoule of heat energy. Now it is clear. Now we will move to the second question. In an experiment, 4.5 kg of fuel was completely burnt. How much? 4.5 kg of fuel. Here the amount of fuel is given. It is completely burnt and the heat produced was measured to be 180,000 kilojoule. Now you have to calculate the calorific value. As we know that the calorific value of a fuel is equal to kilojoule upon kilogram. That is kilojoule, here it is given, amount of heat, the heat produced is this much. So 180,000 kilojoule, and amount of fuel is also given here, 4.5 kg. So 180 kilojoule, 4.5 kg. So 9 fives are 9 twos are 18, then 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4 0. 1, 2, 3 and 4 0. So, the answer 5 again, 5 4s are 20, 1, 2, 3, 4. That means 40,000 joule per kg. This will be the kilojoule, sorry, calorific value of a fuel will be 40,000 kilojoule per kg. That means the heat produced was measured to be this and the calorific value of the fuel is this. Now, we come to the next topic, that is, how can we control fire? So, first of all, children, we will know what are the necessary conditions for combustion, which we already have learnt in a previous class, that what are the necessary conditions for combustion, and these are the necessary conditions for combustion, that is fuel or presence of combustible substance, presence of continuous supply of air or oxygen, and the temperature should be above the ignition temperature of the combustible material. And what we have to do now? We have to control the fire, and these are the conditions for combustion. If any among all these three points, if any of the point is not satisfied, then what will happen? There will be no combustion. So, first point is fuel or presence of combustible substance. Then, the second one is presence of continuous supply of air. And the third one is temperature. So, thus, fire can be controlled, or you can say that it can be stopped by removing any of one condition. Now you can remove the supply of air by lowering the temperature, also you can do. But how will you lower the temperature? We can lower the temperature by pouring simply water on it, on the combustible material. By just pouring water, we can lower its temperature, because the ignition temperature and fire is stopped. It also cuts supply of oxygen, which removes fire. When water is poured in sufficient amount, then it cuts the supply of oxygen. Water is used to control fire, or you can say it is used to extinguish fire when fire is caused by wood or paper. But when the fire is caused by electricity, you cannot pour water. है ना? क्या है कि the presence of the temperature should be above the ignition temperature. So in order to lower down the temperature, we can pour water, because by pouring water we can lower the temperature below the ignition temperature, and automatically what will happen, the fire will be under our control. Just to put off the fire, we can lower down the temperature. But when the temperature is caused by electricity, you cannot put off the fire by pouring water, because as you know that water is a good conductor of electricity, it will prove fatal. That's the reason we never supposed to opt to put off fire by using water in case of electrical current. Now the presence of continuous supply of air should also be there. In order to make the combustion carry on. But if we suppose to stop the supply of oxygen, either by covering it with a blanket or any other things, if we suppose to put off the fire, as we have seen in the earlier experiment, that how we suppose to cover the tumbler and we suppose to put off the fire, that is the lighted candle stops burning when we suppose to cover it. In the same way, when we put off the continuous supply of air, then there is no combustion. Then presence of combustible substance. If the combustible substance is there, then only the combustion is carried on. Otherwise the combustion will automatically stops. Suppose that there is some, one more thing we have to notice, children, that when fire is caused by oil, or you can say petrol, should not be extinguished by water. You know why? Because water is heavier than oil, so it sinks below the oil, and oil will keep on burning on the top. So it can't be extinguished in that manner. So, and the third one is that the presence of combustible substance. You can remove the combustible material or fuel from that area. If some place, suppose that it catch fire, we should then remove the combustible material or fuel, like petrol, LPG, wood or diesel, if it is present nearby area. So in this way we can control the fire. Now come to the next topic, that is fire extinguisher. It is soda acid type fire extinguisher. It consists of a thin glass tube. See here, it is a thin glass tube which is filled with concentrated sulfuric acid. You know what is sulfuric acid and what is concentrated, that is the pure form of sulfuric acid. It is concentrated sulfuric acid, and just here it is a metallic cylinder, and here sodium bicarbonate is kept. Here sodium bicarbonate, it is also known as baking soda. Sodium hydrogen carbonate. And then what happens when there is case of fire? Then this nozzle is struck on the ground, and then what happens? This concentrated sulfuric acid mixes with sodium bicarbonate, and then it releases large amount of carbon dioxide gas along with water and sodium sulfate. The reaction is somewhat like this: sodium hydrogen carbonate, which is also known as sodium bicarbonate. It reacts with this sulfuric acid and forms sodium sulfate plus water and carbon dioxide gas. Now, in order to make it balance, two and two. Now see here whether it is balanced or not. 3 to the 6 oxygen here, 4 and 2, 6 oxygen. Yes, everything is balanced now. Now you see, sodium bicarbonate reacts with sulfuric acid and forms sodium sulfate, water and carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide is used in extinguishing fire, because carbon dioxide is very nice fire extinguisher. It not only forms a blanket over the combustible area, but also it brings down the temperature of the fuel. So this one, how it brings down the temperature? Because it surrounds the, suppose that these are the combustible area, then it forms a blanket, and thus it cut off the supply of oxygen from here, and that's why when there will be no oxygen over here, then the fire will automatically put off. So this carbon dioxide, it shields down, it forms a blanket over oxygen. So the supply of it, it forms a blanket over combustible material so that the supply of oxygen is cut off. So here carbon dioxide, and also when it is released in large amount, then what happens? It expands and cools down the temperature. That's why the temperature is also lowered, so it will act as a better fire extinguisher. And now the second one is here, water is also formed, and this water also, you know that it lowers down the ignition temperature, so thus it also helps in controlling fire. And now sodium sulfate is also formed. Now here one thing you note down, that this sodium sulfate is formed here. So the soda acid type of fire extinguisher may not be used to extinguish electrical burning, you can say. Electrical burning, when there is fire due to electricity, then it should not be used. Why? Because this sodium sulfate in its aqueous solution, it causes electrical shock, because it is good conductor of electricity. In aqueous solution, sodium sulfate acts as a good conductor of electricity. That's why it should not be used to put off fire which is caused by electricity. Now I think the term is clear, children. So what is fire extinguisher and how it works? And now come to the home assignment. The first one is draw a well-labeled diagram of soda acid fire extinguisher. And the second one is, the chapter is completed, and the second one is write the keywords of the chapter dot, that is chapter number 7. Okay, children.